Pakistani media has seen it all. I mean, we have seen what, 4 military regimes. We have fought them out. The struggle has been a very long struggle. And at times it appeared as if we were totally under control of the regime. But again, I mean, this fight for freedom of media continued. And mostly the contribution for this struggle was from the working journalists, the Pakistan Federal Union of Journalists, which is a very strong union. But the kind of censorship, the self-censorship, the kind of controls which we experienced leading up to the 2018 elections have been highly, highly, it's very, very harsh controls. And the focus was on 2 major media, you know, organizations. One was the Jio, Jung and News, which had the reach of about 70% viewers and readers. And Dawn, which was the most credible newspaper of this country. The focus was on these 2 media organizations. And the other media organizations, perhaps, looking at the kind of controls, pressures these 2 organizations were undergoing, they took it as a signal and they corrected their own courses. As far as Dawn was concerned, the newspaper distribution was curtailed. The hawkers were forced to not distribute Dawn at various identified, you know, locations. And Jio was under pressure. The cable operators were instructed not to either put the channel off air or to put it under the last, you know, in the bouquet, the last rank, so that people don't don't take the trouble of going to their last ranking to see Jio. See, actually, censorship as such, there was a time when we were operating under a law called Press and Publication Ordinance. There was a law, and that was a very harsh law, under that law, if a small little minion sitting in the remotest corner of the country were to not like your, say, the color of your jacket, he can throw you behind the bars, you can take over your newspaper, your press, and there would not be any recourse to law. But even there was a law, and the PFUJ, Pakistan Federal Union of Journalists, fought it out in the courts. And the Sharia court at one point declared that law as un-Islamic. So, there was this contest between the PFUJ and the government of the day. And we kept on having a dialogue with the government. But the kind of censorship which was imposed on the media during leading up to the 2018 election were totally different. There was no law, there was no, you know, legally they could not have told a newspaper or a channel not to publish or not to cover an event. But what they did was they used to ring up the people, the management, and threaten them. They used a number of threats, like stopping the advertisements, or even kidnapping journalists, or putting them behind the bars. One editor was actually arrested and put behind the bars for not complying with their instructions. So that way is the self-censorship. And this was the reason why the media, these two organizations were under focus, Geo Jung News and Dawn, being the major vehicles. The lower ones, the smaller ones, just took it as if they have to do exactly what the instructions are being given to them. This proposal which Mr. Fawad Chaudhry, the information minister, has given, that he wants to bring all the press council, PEMRA, and again introduce even the social media into one umbrella of regulatory agency. It's good to talk about such things. It's rhetorically it appears very good, but I have reservations about all the three getting into one organization. How do you handle something? How do you regulate with the same law the social media as well as the broadcast media as well as the newspapers? This is going to be something like I'm not very sure that it's going to succeed. But then again, they have promised that they will liberate PEMRA. The laws of the PEMRA are very good, but as long as they remain under the control of the government, if they are part of the information ministry, any action, even the right action against a media organization, would be taken as if it is being done by the government of the day. So if they liberate PEMRA from the government and make it an autonomous body — autonomous means a statutory body, a body which is formed out of bipartisan, in the parliament. If a parliamentary, committee, bipartisan parliamentary committee, sets up a board of directors representing, across the board, representatives like doctors, lawyers, gender representation in that board, and that board selects the MD, managing director, who would be accountable to the board, and the board accountable to the parliamentary party. That way, perhaps PEMRA would become really effective. A regulatory body has to be not in the hands of the government. PEMRA has to keep a watch on the water and power, ministry. But as of today, they're all part of the ministry, land ministries, and that does not help. Without the media, media actually performs the job of telling the people of the country what their government is doing. And unless the people know what exactly the government is up to, they would not be able to make up their mind about whether this government is doing the right job or the wrong job. So at the end of the 5 years, at the end of the tenure, when they go and vote, they would, if the media is free and media is informing them, giving them the quality information, so that way the democracy is strengthened. But if the media does not inform them what exactly is happening, so the people at large, the voters, are totally blind about what is happening in the country, and that would actually promote dictatorship rather than democracy.